is because of the issue of the qareen and the jinn and the shayateen in general who are whispering to us. And this is the test, ya akhwan. And this is the reality of this life. The fact that the Prophet ﷺ became Muslim and that was something from that was special was given to the Prophet ﷺ. Obviously for us, this is the test. And this is life. You're here to be tested. So obviously he's going to whisper to you. He's going to try to encourage you. From the time you hear the Adhan Fajr, how many excuses does he give you not to go to Salatul Fajr in the masjid? And some of them are really, you know, good advice. You know, okay, he can come up with different fiqh issues and ikhtilafat and things like that and try to convince you not to go. And all the time, he's going to try to convince you. When you see a beautiful lady, look. Allahu Ghafoor Rahim, ya akhi. You're not just looking, ya akhi, you know. Come on, it's not like you're not going to touch it, not going to say anything to her. All you're doing is looking. It's harmless, you know. So this is the test. Do you look or do you look away? So obviously we're always going to be tested. And we have to, you know, obviously, you know, find the things that keep us strong, find the things that make us weak, and then when we fall into these sins, and how he gets us. And this is part of the challenge, subhanAllah. Even I remember a short time back, I was looking into with one of our brothers, who's a practicing brother, a good brother, who worked with us in da'wah, but he kept falling into something was haram, looking at things that were haram. And all of you know what I'm talking about. And subhanAllah, when we researched the issue, we found that the reason he was falling into this, it were some other small sins that he would do, like, yahi, not a big deal. But it would have an impact on his heart. And then later another small sin, and then he would fall into something bigger by looking at what's haram. So it's also, each person has to understand these type of things and how we're influenced and how these whispers influence us and why we're falling into these type of haram things. It's something very interesting. If you sit down and you actually go through it, you could even write it out sometimes. Make sure you get away with the paper so nobody, you don't expose your sins later. But if you were to write it down, and why am I falling into sin? What am I doing before that sin? Why do I keep going astray? Why am I not practicing like I should? And you'll find there's a lot of things that you're doing. It's not just one thing. It could be several small things that make you fall into something that's big. So this is all part of the challenge and how to deal with it. And Allah knows best. Allahu a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa jazakum Allahu khairan.